Happy Paul Skeens Day for all those who celebrate.
You are Locked On MLB, your daily MLB podcast. Part of the Locked On Podcast Network, your team every day.
Hello, baseball fans, and welcome to Locked On MLB, part of the Locked On Podcast Network, where it's your team every day. This is the daily podcast. We talk about all of Major League Baseball. I am your host, Paul Francis Sullivan. If you don't believe me, why would I have a lower third room called Sully? I have been a baseball podcast for well over a decade now. I'm in my sixth season as a host here at the Locked On Podcast Network, where it is your team every day. Follow us at Locked On MLB Pods on Twitter or on Instagram. I'm your pal Sully. I'm at Sully Baseball on Twitter, Sully Baseball Podcast on Instagram. If you listen to us every day and want to post something on one of our social media sites, put that hashtag EverydaySully. It helps us keep track of who's listening every day. And by the way, if you like this show and you like what I'm doing, you can get a bonus episode every week by subscribing to Locked On A's. Because, it's not enough that I'm giving you five baseball podcasts a week, pretty much all year long. I have jumped in and become at least the interim host, and I've been the host since pretty much the beginning of the year. So who knows? I'll probably be here the whole year for the Oakland A's and their final year in Oakland. And it's been a fun year in Oakland so far. Who would have guessed that they would be at least hovering around 500 as we're entering into mid-May? Hey, I asked a trivia question yesterday. A couple of you got it wrong. One of you did get it right. The question was, who is the only number one overall pick in the draft who went on to clinch either a league championship series or World Series? In other words, be the pitcher on the mound when they gets the final out. And there you go. A couple of you guessed Steven Strasburg. That's not correct. The correct answer is actually David Price. David Price was the correct answer. He got the final out of the 2008 American League Championship Series when he, just fresh out of college, closed out Game 7 ALCS for Tampa Bay to win the pennant against the Red Sox. He had a clashing rivalry with the Red Sox as a pitcher for the Rays, but oddly would win his ring as a member of the Red Sox in 2018, in a year where there was a lot of shenanigans from that Red Sox team. And I know some people don't like to acknowledge it. And if you don't want to acknowledge that year, I'm not going to fight you. A lot of stuff to talk about. In the majority of today's episode, I was a guest on Locked On Pirates, which is hosted by our good friend Ethan Smith. And the two of us talked about the fact that the number one pitching prospect in baseball, and arguably the top prospect in all of baseball, Paul Skeens, is making his debut, his eagerly anticipated debut with the Pittsburgh Pirates over this weekend. And we talked about the ramifications of the call-up, what he could mean to the Pirates, what he could mean for aces coming up through the system. I'm excited to see him pitch on the big league level. But before we do that, let's take a look to see who owned baseball on Thursday, as this is being dropped sometime on Friday. I'm not 100% sure, but because I don't have set times for these deliveries, but let's figure out who owned baseball at least on Thursday. Darren Blanco got on base four times, including a home run, and stole two bases as the Royals rolled to a 10-4 win. That's a CB radio call, 10-4 over the Angels. The Royals look pretty good. They look pretty good. They could potentially win that AL Central. Brenton Doyle hit a home run and a double as the Rockies pounded San Francisco 9-1. The Rockies don't look very good, but Doyle certainly looked good for them last night or on Thursday night. And so did Cal Quantrill, who threw six strong innings and held the Giants to just one run, got the 9-1 decision for Colorado. And Pablo Lopez struck out 10 Mariners, walked none over 6 1/3 innings as the Twins took the 11-1 final over the Seattle Mariners. Earning half walks was Anthony Volpe of the Yankees, who singled and homered, but the Astros beat the Yankees 4-3. Buck Farmer pitched a strong scoreless ninth inning to try to set the Reds up to walk off in the ninth, but they were held off. Luke Weaver also pitched well out of the bullpen, giving the Yankees an inning and a third of shutout relief. But the Astros did win that 4-3. And Yimer Candelario got a homer, added another hit, but the Reds lost 5-4. So earning full wobs, Darian Blanco, Brenton Doyle, Pablo Lopez, and Cal Quantrill. Learning half wobs are Yimer Candelario, Buck Farmer, Anthony Volpe, and Luke Weaver. We've got a fun slate of games coming up. But first, let's have a little bit of that conversation I had with Ethan Smith, where we discussed the Pirates, their new star, and ace pitchers in general.
And ever since he was drafted 1-1, Sully, the expectation was that he was going to be up here very quickly, obviously coming up today on Saturday, and making it a pretty big deal because he's going to be the fastest 1-1 to be up in almost 35 years.
Right.
He's a guy that absolutely teared through the minor league system, has a sub-2 ERA overall in 12 starts, a sub-1 ERA in 7 quote-unquote starts this year, where he was going about 3 or 4 innings, maybe 5 here and there. And it's already a big deal that Skeens is coming up, but you mentioned also that Jared Jones is fully involved in the Rookie of the Year conversation and has set those expectations even higher. But what do you think the impact on Major League Baseball is with Paul Skeens not only debuting, but debuting for a smaller team, rather, as in the Pittsburgh Pirates, as some would say?
Well, I think this is an interesting calling up a player like this. It reminds me a little bit of when David Price basically went from college to basically to the World Series. Now, granted, the Rays didn't use him as an ace pitcher right out of the gate, but he became a huge weapon. Just ask any Red Sox fan. He became a huge weapon. It was the guy on the mound when they clinched the pennant in 08. Another one who should have gone 1-1 was Verlander, but the Padres passed on because they wanted Matt Bush. I'm sure they're fine with that. But, you know, he only made a couple of starts in 05, but came up and made a huge impact in his rookie year when he won the Rookie of the Year and the Tigers went to the World Series. And, of course, he had another – I think the last one we've had that was this kind of anticipation was probably Steven Strasburg. Ace is a dying breed. The ace is a dying animal. And we saw that. We had a player who won – is the defending Cy Young Award winner who nobody wanted. And I think part of that is they're no longer having pitchers be the 200 innings eater type pitchers that were still kicking around Verlander and Scherzer. We'd still be kicking around Greinke if we could, but we're no longer developing ace pitchers. And I think for an economic reason, I think people, because of all pitch counts, they can't go more than two ways through there. I think that's a bunch of hogwash. I think what it is, it's economics. They see that the Kershaws and the Scherzers are so expensive, then let's create a way of doing pitching that doesn't need a big ace pitcher. That you can, we just need you to pitch 5 innings. So, of course, we're seeing the issues of that because you have these bullpens are worn down to the nub because they're not letting their star pitchers, you know, pitch into the six anymore. Skeens is going to be an interesting case of, are they going to allow him to be an ace? Are they going to allow him to go deep into games? Are they going to allow him to pitch 6 or 7 innings? And, of course, we got to hope that he can make it, that inevitably every pitcher, it's the law. It's actually written in the collective bargaining agreement. Every pitcher has to have Tommy John surgery almost immediately, no matter how you treat them, which is one reason why I like that the Pirates are bringing him up because, well, if he's going to have Tommy John surgery, let's get those innings on the major league level. Yeah. But I think that I'm rooting for him. I miss having not just growing up where there were the, you know, Clemens and the, you know, the Oral Hershisers or the Fernando Valenzuelas or even the Burt Blylevens and people like that who, you know, you knew were going to give you 7 or 8 innings. I miss the Felix Hernandezes of the world. I miss the John Lesters of the world. You give them the ball, and your bullpen can say, okay, we're only going to, you know, we can kind of have a night off. I mean, Sabathia was that way. Cliff Lee was that way. All the players that the Cleveland Indians botched in trades were that way. And we haven't really seen a new generation of those kind of pitchers because of the economics. I'm sorry, it doesn't have to do with stats. It doesn't have to do with sabermetrics. It has to do with money. Ace pitchers cost a lot. So let's not use them anymore. We can piecemeal a bullpen. We're starting to see that doesn't work. And so I would love it if Skeens was part of a new generation of potential ace pitchers. And he's, and for Pirate fans who are worried that he's going to leave via free agency, well, then enjoy the time you have with him. Okay, clearly I am a fashion plate. Clearly you take a look at someone sitting in the basement wearing a Washington Senators t-shirt, you know that this guy knows his clothes. But you know what? There are times where I do dress very well. In fact, it happened just the other day when I'd have a parent-teacher conference. You know, I'm a teacher. I wanted to look good. I wanted to look well-dressed. I didn't want to show up in a baseball t-shirt. And you know where I went to get my look? I went to Stitch Fix. Now, Stitch Fix, you get a stylist who understands your style, your size, and budget, and they do all the shopping for you. It's the easiest way to update your wardrobe this season. Now, you can easily upgrade your wardrobe with a professional stylist, and they go find the new on-trend favorites that will work just for you. I gave them my size. I gave stylists my style. I gave stylists my budget preference. I order boxes when I want and how I want. No subscription is required. And they send 5 just for me pieces, outfit recommendations, and pro styling advice. I keep it works and I send back the rest. My stylist always sends the just right pieces and fit is on point. It's like they've got ESP, but for fashion. I don't know how they do it. Could be magic. Stitch Fix makes it all so easy. I don't like to shop. That's not for me. They save me that time. They save me that effort. Plus, I get outfits that make me look good, make me feel good, give me that little bit of confidence. If you don't love something, just give it back. Shipping, returns, and exchanges, they're always free. So the style that makes you feel as good as you look, get started today with stitchfix.com/MLB. Get $20 off your first fix. That's stitchfix.com/MLB for $20 off. stitchfix.com/MLB. Must redeem within 7 days of sign up. Stitch Fix. Do you know what? You're looking good. Hey, where is your go-to place for all things sports? If you want to have the best news, analysis, and breakdown of the games, here's where you should head to. You should head to Locked On Sports Today. Locked On Sports Today is a free 24/7 sports streaming channel program for you every day to bring you the best stories with the Locked On team. Locked On Sports Today gives you can't miss analysis, opinions, and news streaming 24/7 on YouTube or the free Fire Amazon TV channels app. Part of the Locked On Podcast Network, where it's your team every day. Okay, let's get back to our conversation with Ethan Smith about the new ace for the Pirates. There's a thing that I think is very interesting for the Pirates and for the 2024 Pirates. And I'd love to have your take on this. The Pirates are not going to be one of the elite teams, but 84-85 wins will punch you a playoff ticket. And every win you can get, every win you can steal here and there, with a better pitcher here or a better matchup there, facing a bad team here or there, could be the difference between where the Cubs were last year and where Arizona was last year, where the Brewers were 2 years ago and where Philadelphia was. And you notice that the other team I'm mentioning happens to be the one that goes to the World Series. Not saying it's a Pirate World Series year, but there is a glut. And you remember we did the power rankings earlier this week. Really between I made the point of the show, between 9 and 24, just pick them out of a bag. It's just a bunch of teams that are going to finish between 78 and 83 wins. And so if the difference between the playoffs is 85 wins as opposed to 83 wins, then having a good pitcher, even for a small period of time, grab a few wins here or there. You've got, you know, Mitch Keller, who looked a lot better his last start. You got Jared Jones, who's having a terrific start. Martin Perez is a talented pitcher. Bailey Falter has his ups and downs, as per his name. Quinn Priester has had some decent games, some not decent games. But if you are consistently, I mean, maybe, you know, I'm about to make a bold statement here. But if you're consistently having a decent pitcher on the mound, then you're going to win more often than you're not. But if you want to save the innings for Skeens, you don't want to blow him out too much. Here's my modest proposal. Every other day, he pitches two innings, and they're the eighth and ninth. He comes out because Bednar ain't doing it this year.
No.
His ERA is an area code. So yeah. I think every win you get here or there will help the Pirates potentially be one of those teams. What do you think about my madness?
Well, and I'm thinking too, and this is a point that I made both on Twitter or X or whatever we call it now, and on my show.
I call it MySpace.
It's a pretty good name for it too. That when you look at it, you're looking at a guy in Keller that you've already shown a willingness to extend. You're showing a willingness to make him one of your guys. You have Jared Jones, who I mentioned earlier, obviously a guy that has done a lot as a rookie already, firmly in the rookie of the year conversation with Shoto Imanaga and Yoshinobu Yamamoto. Then you have Martin Perez, who they went out and got in the offseason, and I advocated for that very early in the offseason to go get a guy like that. He's done well. And you mentioned Priester and Falter. One of those guys will likely leave the rotation for in favor of Skeens. But I wanted to highlight this stretch specifically, and obviously we're recording this on Thursday. This will drop Saturday, so we don't know the result of the Friday game just yet.
Not yet.
But you're going into a stretch against the Cubs and the Brewers where you're going to play them 10 consecutive games. Exactly. You do not have a stretch like that again. Trust me, my trusty little thing right here showed me that they do not have a stretch like that again. And you can tell me now that when they called up Skeens on Wednesday and announced he was going to start today on Saturday, that 8 out of those 10 games, you were going to have Keller, Perez, Skeens, and Jones going. I like their chances in those games.
Yes.
I mean, there's really only two pitchers, maybe three or four, that scare me from Milwaukee and Chicago. Three of those four are Cubs, and one is a Milwaukee Brewer, and I don't know if we see Freddy Peralta. Shoto Imanaga's advanced numbers don't exactly prove a lot to me that he's as great as he's been. He's been good, His advanced numbers don't suggest that it's sustainable. Justin Steele's Justin Steele. He's just phenomenal. And then Javier Assad's playing over his head right now. But when you're telling me that you can have two rookie phenoms, really, at this point in Jones and Skeens, a guy that you went out and extended in Mitch Keller who can give you those good strong starts like he did Tuesday in the complete game, and Martin Perez, who's a veteran steady presence that you know that you can usually count on, that's going to give you a leg up, like you said, in a division that's very winnable, because a lot of Pirates fans, yes, this stretch over the last couple of weeks has been frustrating. They're 5 games back at the time of recording.
Right.
Those 5 games can be picked up very fast in this next 10-game stretch.
Exactly. And this is a critical time because, as you said, it isn't like years past where they'll be playing each other 19 times during the regular season. This is a year where those head-to-head matchups are a premium. Mm-hmm. And to make up those games, you're almost, I mean, it almost would be, if they want to keep playing games with his service time and everything like that, call him up for this stretch and then send him back down, or like, you know, rest him up a little bit, but use him for this period of time. You know, you're right. I mean, if you have the better pitcher out each time, you know, as of this recording, Milwaukee is in first place, if I'm not mistaken. Yes. You know, Chicago is, as of this recording, half game back. So it's been tight, but no one has taken off with that division. No. And the Reds are in the middle of a horrific streak, and the Cardinals are legitimately bad. And so you have to look forward. And in terms of, I know it's early to, you know, I don't start looking at the wildcard standings until after Memorial Day. It's really start June is when you can start looking at there and see where you fit. But as of this recording, the Pirates are only 2 games out of a playoff spot, which is my point, that there's the only 2 teams that you legitimately can say don't have a shot this year are Miami and Colorado in terms of the National League.
Yeah, and mentioning this too, and it's a point that you've made on Locked On Pirates and Locked On MLB when I've been on that show all the time, is putting your best 26 players on the roster. Mm-hmm. It's very hard to argue that Paul Skeens, even currently without him throwing a pitch yet, is not one of the 26 best guys on this roster. And you're mentioning about how close this can be. between 83 and 85 wins, or even 81 and 83 wins. If Paul Skeens can come up, Sully, and I want your thoughts on this, and be a plus two wins above replacement player, that's all he has, two wins above replacement. That could be the difference between the Pirates either being a contending baseball team or just sitting at home again.
And where I will defend the Pirates as well, how they handled things. Obviously, he looked fantastic in spring training, but he did only have 6 2/3 professional innings under his belt.
Yes.
Yeah, it was. I have no problem with them saying, let's put him in AAA and see what he can do. Well, we saw he made mincemeat out of AAA. I mean, I have his stats in front of me. He struck out 45 batters in 27 and a third innings. He laid up 3 earned runs. He only walked 8. I mean, that's an ERA under 1. Okay. Yeah. And I know ERA is not always the most reliable of stats, but when that first number is a 0, you're okay. Good. You're doing okay. Policy Genius is the nation's leading online marketplace. It saves you time and money so you can provide your family with a financial security net starting today. With Policy Genius, you can find life insurance policies that start at just $292 a year for $1 million worth of coverage. Some options offer same-day approval and avoid unnecessary medical exams. Life could be unpredictable, and Policy Genius can take away some of the worries of what your family would do if something happened. Policy Genius gives you unbiased advice from a licensed expert support team. They have no incentive to recommend one insurer over another, so you can trust their guidance. Thousands of 5-star reviews on Google and Trustpilot from customers who found the best fit for their needs with Policy Genius. Check life insurance off your to-do list in no time with Policy Genius. Head to policygenius.com/lockedonMLB or click the link in the description to get your free life insurance quotes and see how much you can save. That's policygenius.com/lockedonMLB. All right, I know my mom's listening to this, and this is going to be our last chance to talk about this before Mother's Day. Mom, I'm getting you a present. Don't worry. I know it's very important for you, but I'm not going to tell you what it is. I'm not going to tell you if it's going to be flowers for the kitchen island or the chicken island. You know, the island of chickens that you frequent often. I'm not getting you any flowers for the chicken island. This is when you do these live reads. I'm not going to get you self-care essentials. And I'm not going to get you the best tech, or maybe I am. I don't know. I'm not going to tell you how we're getting it. But I'll do you a favor. I'll tell you that you're getting them through DoorDash. We will get savings that will make you proud of us, Mom. And with a Dash Pass membership, we will save with a $0 delivery fee and reduce service fees on eligible orders from Dash Pass merchants that meet the minimum subtotal. Other fees, including service fees, apply and terms apply. You too can order now and get everything you need for Mother's Day on DoorDash. Use code LOCKEDONMLB for 50% off your next order, up to $15 when you spend $15 or more on your next flower, convenience, grocery, or retail order now on DoorDash. That's promo code LOCKEDONMLB. Order using DoorDash today. Terms apply. And don't worry, Mom, you're going to get it. This is a quick reminder that Locked On has created the first ever national sports 24/7 streaming channel on YouTube, and now it's available on Amazon Fire TV and the free Fire TV channel app. Locked On Sports Today is here for you 24/7, covering the top sports stories of the day, with the local experts of Locked On, our national shows covering every league. Find Locked On Sports Today now available on the free Fire TV's channel app. All right, let's finish up our discussion with Ethan Smith from Locked On Pirates. I remember... This was before I had my podcast. I had the old Sully Baseball podcast. I remember urging, like on my blog, the old Sully Baseball blog, if you want to look that up in the archives. But I was urging, if the Nationals were putting such a cap on Strasburg's innings, then let's be creative. Let's stretch those out and have him pitch in the middle innings. Let's do something, like I said, like every 3 days he pitches two innings at the end of the game. Let's use it so you have your best pitcher available when they're going to the postseason. Okay, if it wasn't used as a starter, fine. Well, I don't know if they're going to be putting any innings limits. I don't see anywhere where innings limits has really helped preserve pitchers. But as long as they have Skeens and they have a shot, because they're a team that does not play in Denver or Miami, they have a shot to be a playoff team. And if you say, go, we don't, I can understand them saying we don't want to throw 200 innings. Fine. Yeah. The most he ever threw in college was 122. I understand that. But if you want him to pitch, like, let's say 130 or 140 innings in the majors, or even 100, you could be creative in where you stretch those innings out, because they actually still have a decent starting rotation. Yeah. So if you could take advantage of that, mind you, here are some pitchers who came up like that. Jim Palmer came up like that, came out of the bullpen when he came up. Jimmy Key came up like that, came out of the bullpen. Oral Hershiser came up like that, out of the bullpen. That used to be a strategy. Chris, that's what Chris Sale did. His first year with the Chicago White Sox, when he came out of college, he was a highly touted prospect. They used him out of the pen the first year. So they're able to use his stretch and be able to you know, take advantage of that. And they gave him great uniforms and a pair of scissors. But the idea that they have Skeens, that this is like an automatic death march to the inevitable Tommy John, they don't have to do it that way. I'm going to go out on a limb and say he might be more effective than David Bednar this year, or Aroldis Chapman, or, you know, who else is in there?
Well, Colin Holderman's had a pretty good start to the year, I believe. His ERA is sub two still. So we've seen pretty good things. And Bednar, too, over the last couple of weeks has looked a lot better than what he did in April. But to end this, Sully, I'll just ask you the one question about everything. How do we think Skeens does today? What's a stat line you think you could tell Pirates fans? I've had it in my head that it'll be about five innings, about one or two earned runs maybe, or shutout, but I don't think he'll allow more than two against a struggling Cubs offense. What are your thoughts on it? How do you think he competes, especially going against Justin Steele for the Chicago Cubs?
I don't think you can look at the opposing pitcher at this point. This is not a boxing match. The Pirates bats have to deal with their own Pirates bats. I don't look at the win losses. There's so many times, you know, the great Harvey Haddocks of the Pirates will show you, look that up. It doesn't matter. Mm-hmm. And Steele is pitching, correct?
Yes.
Okay. And, you know, obviously Steele is an excellent pitcher. Look, I think that realistically he's going to throw five innings. He's not going to go more than that. I think he's going to allow one run. I think he's going to strike out six and walk two.
Sounds reasonable enough. And I've already said it to everybody that I expect it to be a playoff-like atmosphere at PNC Park. I will be there later today in attendance with many other podcasters, many other media folks, and, of course, all of you wonderful Pirates fans here in the Locked On Podcast Network and the Locked On Pirates podcast.
All right. Thanks, Ethan Smith. And, well, we're going to see what happens. It's always fun when you see one of the potential new stars out there. Now let's take a quick peek before we get going on the scores, who's going to be playing on this weekend. You're going to see the Astros and the Tigers. It's the A.J. Hinch series. Believe it or not, the Tigers are better than the Astros right now. Now we know that the Skeens start is on Saturday for the Pirates. Jones is pitching for the Pirates over the Cubs today. The Yankees and the Rays are locking antlers. Schmidt versus Bradley in this game. The D-backs, who went to the World Series last year, against the Orioles, who want to go to the World Series this year, Fott versus Irvin there. The Nats are playing the Red Sox. Corbin is off to a rough start. Hauk is off to a terrific start for the Sox. The Twins and the Blue Jays, a red-hot Twins team and a very confused Blue Jays team, are matching up Ryan Kikuchi right there. The Mets want to get back into this. They're at 500 right now, and they're facing off against Atlanta. Quintana pitching for the Mets. Morton for Atlanta. The Phillies are one of the best teams in baseball. The Marlins are one of the worst. Suarez and Rogers are facing off on that. A big advantage to Philadelphia. Watch the Marlins win. The Cardinals and the Brewers. If the Cardinals want to get back, beating the first-place Brewers will go a long way. Carrasco is pitching for the Guardians, and Crochet is pitching for the White Sox in a matchup of AL Central teams. The Rangers and the Rockies are playing in Denver. The Royals and the Angels are playing on Apple TV right down the street here in Anaheim, with Marsh pitching for Kansas City. You have the Dodgers and the Padres, Glasnow, King, two excellent teams facing off right there. The Reds and the Giants. We're going to see if Webb can pitch well against a Reds team that is trying to get their footing. And, of course, if you're following Locked On A's, you'll know that the A's are playing the Mariners, as the A's are trying to sneak closer to second place. Which brings us to today's trivia question. We talked a lot about the Pirates. It's this simple. Who was the last Pirate to lead the league in stolen bases? That's your trivia question. Put it right down here at Locked On MLB Pods. On Twitter and Instagram, I'm your pal Sully with Sully Baseball on Twitter. Sully Baseball Podcast on Instagram. Joining us with Ethan Smith of Locked On Pirates, this has been Locked On MLB. I am your host, Paul Francis Sullivan. Please call me Sully.